Every year we drive out to Cape Cod for the last part of June. So leave the city by 10 and you're there in the late afternoon. On the way, there's a town called Marion that you pass through. The first time I approached it, I'll always remember the sign that came into view. It said, entering Marion. And I thought, what a neat little sign. The feeling of entering Marion had a kick that was hard to define. A rapturous rush, a physical flush, chills up and down the spine. The few minutes I was in Marion, all Massachusetts was mine. Next year, God knows why, I decided to try a new route. So, I brought out my map, and I traced what I thought was a route. After driving all morning, I came to the top of a hill, where a sign stood before me that offered a new kind of thrill. It said, entering Beverly, which was lovely and not overbuilt. But the feeling of entering Beverly far outweighed any feelings of guilt. I could say I'm contrite, but it wouldn't be right, because the truth is that later that day, I found myself entering Sharon. It was there, so was I. We enjoyed it. Hey, what can I say? By next year, I try any route just for novelty's sake. I've been great with a thirst that no single township could slake. Oh, by the wheel, I looked calm, but inside I was running amok. When a sign in the road dead ahead sent me straight into shock. Entering Lawrence. Oh God, I was out of control. And I'm no sooner finished with Lawrence than boom, I was entering Lowell. So I backtracked and re-entered Lawrence, and Quincy and Norton as well. And just when I pulled out of Milton, I dropped in a Fleabag motel. Oh my word. I slept fitfully till the dawn was breaking, wrestling with this promiscuous route I'd been taking, winding my way into Darien. A sign came clear as a clarion. Hours time, I was entering Marion. How totally wonderfully great, how grand to be entering Marion after tramping all over the state. Every flea bucket burb, every tryst by the curb, it really just helped me to find the happiest entering Marion, I guess.